إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار Brothers and sisters in Islam إن من كبر اليقينيات أو من كبر اليقينيات One of the greatest certainties that we were created in this world to be tested. If you ponder upon the text in the Quran and in the Sunnah, you will find out that you were created to be tested. قال الله تعالى وهو الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام وكان عرشه على الماء ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days and his throne was on water, above the water And he created you to be tested. قال الله تعالى Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Kahf This verse I just quoted in Surah Hud Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Kahf إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا مَا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ زِينَةً لَهَا لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا Indeed, whatever adornment we placed in earth, it is just a means of you for you to be tested. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Mulk, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفُورُ Blessed is Allah who has the dominion Who owns everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's able to do everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He created death and life for you to be tested. وَالْإِنسَانُ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا أَيُّهَا الْإِخْوَةُ الْمُسْلِمُونَ يُبْتَلَى عَلَى وَجْهَيْنِ And a person in this dunya, He goes through two kinds of tests. Pay attention to this because it will build up. We're going somewhere with this. الابتلاء الكوني والابتلاء الشرعي. The first kind is called الكوني, meaning whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed upon you. And the other kind is الشرعي, where you really have a choice in this one, is making yourself a slave to Allah, a servant to Allah, willingly obeying Allah, becoming a Muslim. Quickly, as for the first type, because our focus is on the second type, the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us is a test for us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us by good and bad. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Anbiya, كل نفس ذائقة الموت, every soul shall taste death, ونبلوكم بالشر والخير فتنة, and we shall test you with good and bad. Allah shall test you with money, wealth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall test you with poverty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall test you with health. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall test you with illness. But both are tests. Look, because a lot of people do not realize that these things are tests by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَّمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا. And when mankind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him rich, has a status, he is honored in earth, he will say, surely Allah has honored me above my race. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse, in Surah Al-Fajr, used the verb test him. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ, tests him with that. In the other hand, وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ, the same verb, and when he tests him, فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا. And when he makes his means so limited, he will say, Allah surely has humiliated me. The next word, brothers and sisters in Islam, في هذه الصورة, in this surah, كَلَّا, meaning no. You are wrong thinking that luxury is a means of being honored, and you are wrong thinking poverty is a means of being humiliated. Both of you are tested. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when you're tested with something good, to succeed in this test, be grateful. Be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we're just going to use wealth, because it's the most common item in the mind of a lot of us. Be grateful to Allah for the wealth, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made you wealthy. How? Believe in the depth of your heart that the wealth that you have is from Allah. Not because you went to Harvard, or you went to PhD, or you went... Yeah, these are means that Allah guided you to. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the Quran, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Every ni'mah, every favor, every good thing that you have is given to you by Allah. حَتَّى الْإِيمَانِ, حتى الإيمان, even iman, even faith. is a ni'mah, a bounty bestowed upon you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you must confess in your heart that what you have is from Allah. And you know better than Yusuf when he said, ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي. This is what my Lord has taught me. The second way, or the second, we're talking about how can you be grateful. In brief, you must be kufit. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Speak of the bounty of Allah upon you. But don't speak in a boastful manner. Don't speak in a way to show that I'm better than you, I'm wealthy. Allah made me wealthier than you. La, la, la. Show the people how you got that wealth. Allah blessed me with what I have. Three brothers and sisters in Islam, use the bounty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you in the obedience of Allah. It doesn't make any sense if Allah bestows upon you wealth. You go and open a liquor store, lottery store, sell khinzir, sell the things that Allah made haram with the wealth of Allah, with the bounty of Allah. You use it to disobey Allah. And four, أدي حق الله في حق الله فيها. If you have to pay zakah, pay zakah. Give the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that ni'mah that you have. If you done this, you pass that test. You pass that test. If Allah bestowed upon you a bounty, be grateful. And this is how you become grateful. In the depth of your heart, you believe it's from Allah. One. Two. Speak of it to show people the source. Three. Use it in the obedience of Allah. Do not use it in the disobedience of Allah. Four. Give the right of the people in that bounty. Zakah. What about the other type, which is what we would say bad? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed upon you something bad. You did not earn in a way. Allah wrote upon you that you are to be poor. Or maybe you're wealthy and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away your wealth. There is one thing only, brothers and sisters in Islam, that you must do. A password. Patience. Be patient. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. We shall test you with shortage, with some fear, hunger, shortage of food, provision. Give glad tidings to those who are patient. لَتُبْلَوُنَّ فِي أَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ وَلَتَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا أَذًا كَثِيرًا وَإِنْ تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. You shall test it by people. They shall harm you. Whether they are the people of the book or the mushriks, the disbelievers, be patient. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is not a sign of humiliation that Allah tests you with something bad. As a matter of fact, this is the wrong way to look at it. Look at the most beloved people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen, entrusted to deliver His deen, His message to the rest of the human race. أنا أتحدث عن الأنبياء. I'm talking about the messengers and the prophets. How they were tested. سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه كما صح في سنن الترمذي. One day asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, من أشد الناس بلاء? Who are the people who are tested most? قال الأنبياء. He said the prophets. ثُمَّ الصَّالِحُونَ Then the righteous. ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَلُ فَالْأَمْثَلُ Then ranks down. وَيُبْتَلَى الْمَرْءُ عَلَىٰ قَدْرِ دِينِهِ And a person will be tested according to his deen. فَإِنْ وُجِدَ فِي دِينِهِ صَلَابَةٌ زِيدَ لَهُ فِي الْبَلَاءِ If his deen is strong, his test will be elevated. Because there are a lot of wisdoms behind these tests. And this is not my subject of today. Maybe I will talk about this in a later khutbah. Allah expiates your sins because of these tests. Allah elevates your ranks because of these tests. Allah makes you stronger. Because the most important limb in your body is your heart. And for you to know the nutrition of the heart is these tests. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you meet the good with gratefulness, and if you meet what you would consider bad, based on that understanding now, with patience, then you have passed the test. وَصَدَقَ عَلَيْكَ قَوْلُ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ And the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would then apply to you. كما في صحيح مسلم من حديث صهيب ابن سنان الرومي أبي يحيى رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم عجبا لأمر المؤمن فإن أمره كله له خير إن أصابته سراء شكر فكان خيرا له وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءُ صَبَرٌ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, I'm amazed at the lifestyle, all the affairs of a believer. All his lifestyle is good. Everything that befalls a believer is good. When a good thing befalls upon him, he says, Alhamdulillah, it's good for him. And Allah increases him. وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ And when something bad befalls him, he is patient. And this is also good for him. Brothers and sisters in Islam, as for the second type of tests that we go through, وَهُوَ الْإِبْتِلَاءُ الشَّرْعِيُّ And this is, by the way, I'm taking you to this. And this will take us somewhere else. Just hang in there. What do you mean by al-ibtila' al-shar'i? Al-takalif. Al-awamir wal-nawahi. Do, do not do. You're a Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I have not created you But to worship me. Linguistically speaking, النفي بما والنفي بلا ثم الاستثناء يقصد به الحصر والقصر. If you negate a statement by لا and ما and then you make an exception, this means in Arabic caging. That means the only purpose behind your creation is to become a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What about work? What about money? مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ Immediately after it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the argument that you may have. I will provide for you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ Allah is the provider. Just do what you created for. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide it for you. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ In the heaven is your provision, is your provision. Whatever you were promised, فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ By the Lord of the heavens and the earth, it is true, like you're saying it. that your rizq, your provision is in the hand of Allah. A Bedouin heard that verse being recited. He said, "Man aghdab al-jaleel hatta aqsam." Who made Allah angry that he had to take an oath for you to believe that? Then you were fashioned, brothers and sisters in Islam, to worship Allah. And this is your second test in this earth. With this one, you have a choice. And that is why it's so difficult. So difficult. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instilled or installed مجازا أن أستخدم هذا وأستغفر الله إذا كان لا يجوز لي هذا instilled inside you the liberty to choose. إنا هديناه السبيل إما شاكرا وإما كفورا. We have shown him the two way, gratefulness and disbelief. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. And by the soul and the one who fashioned it, and he made it tuned, ready to go to goodness, to righteousness, to piety, and to wickedness. You have the choice. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Successful is the one who takes it to the path of righteousness. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. And a loser is the one who does otherwise. Something worthy of mentioning, that your happiness, أخي, my sister, my brother in Islam, is in that servitude, in becoming a slave to Allah. And I insist to use this word slave, even so in the culture here, is a little bit tackling word. A slave, because of the past history, a slave to Allah. A slave to Allah. Don't think that you benefit Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the Quran, إِن تَكْفُرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. If you disbelieve, Allah is all self-sufficient. He does not need you. But if you're grateful, meaning that you believe, then this is something good. And this meaning is so clear and beautiful. And this is the beauty of the sunnah, the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Once it explains the book of Allah, كما في الحديث الإلهي حديث أبي ذر الغفاري رضي الله عنه والحديث في صحيح مسلم قال الله تعالى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, حديث قدسي, a sacred speech of Allah that was left, the meaning was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the wording was left to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to express it in his own words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إني حرمت الظلم على يا عبادي إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. And in the hadith, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم اجتمعوا على أتقى رجل منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا. If the first of you, the last of you, will have the heart of the most righteous of you, this will not increase anything, add anything to what I have. In the other hand, ولو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم اجتمعوا على أفجر رجل منكم ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيئا. If the first of you and the last of you, ins and jinn, gather to have the heart of the wickedest, the most wicked person in the face of this earth, this will not decrease anything from what I have. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you are in a mission to enslave yourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make yourself abd lillah. A lot of Muslims agree 100% with that. They believe that. But a lot of Muslims, they do not realize that there are three enemies. Ala al-rasad. They are standing. Their mission is to distract you from achieving that servitude to Allah. They don't want that. They want you to fail. Do you know who are those enemies? Do you know how they fight you? Do you know how can you defend yourselves from them? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, العدو الأول, the first enemy is you, نفسك التي بين جنبتيك, an enemy that resides inside you, sleeps with you, eats with you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم himself used to seek refuge with Allah from that enemy. In all of his sermons, he used to say, وَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of ourselves. And he taught حسين بن عبيد رضي الله عنه, the father of Imran, when he became a Muslim, this beautiful dua. He told him, Ya Hussein, call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, Allahumma alhimni rushdi waqini sharra nafsi. O Allah, guide me, give me the light of the heart and protect me from the evil of my nafs. And he taught us, kama sah, to make a supplication in the morning. Allahumma bi rahmatika astaghith. He said, wala takilni ila nafsi tarfata ayn. Do not let my nafs be in control of me for the blink of an eye. Wa fi riwaya, wala aqalla min dhalik. Not even less than that. Adu. Nafs. Nafs jubilat ala hubb al-ajilah. This soul that you have was fashioned to love the quick passing. And I'll give you a practical evidence in your lives. If you are a father, have you ever punished your child for not playing? You only punish them for not doing the duties that are heavy on the nafs. and making yourself a slave to Allah, fulfilling the commands of Allah, fulfilling the amana that you vowed that you will fulfill, is heavy on the nafs. Praying 5 times is heavy. Fasting is heavy. Why people are seeking imams and scholars who can make the deen easier a little bit? Come on, make it a modern Islam. Because it's heavy on the nafs. He wants Islam to submit to him. He does not want to submit to the commands. That's what he wants. And nafs, that's the first enemy. The second enemy, adul ins, the human enemy. And they can be the closest to you. قال الله تعالى, addressing the believers, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن من أزواجكم وأولادكم عدوا لكم فاحذروهم. They can be actually the closest to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, addressing the believers, some of your wives, spouse, husband, wives, husbands, wives, children can be enemy to you. If they take you away from achieving al-ubudiyyah, servitude, why do you go to the mosque all the time? Spend more time with us. Why do we have to learn that stuff now? Just worry about making a living. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the Quran that those kins that you have, they will be ready to ransom you in the day of resurrection. They will be ready to ransom you, to sell you out. يُبَصَّرُونَهُمْ. In the day of resurrection, the family members will see one another. يَوَدُّ الْمُجْرِمُ لَوْ يَفْتَدِي مِنْ عَذَابِ يَوْمِئِذٍ بِبَنِيهِ. A transgressor would love to ransom himself from the punishment of Allah using his children. Oh Allah, can you take my child just for me to be spared? يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه. Sometimes your enemy from the ins is not a family member. It's someone that you adore. Man, I feel so good with this guy. I just find myself with this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the day of resurrection, الْأَخِلَّاءُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٍ إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ. Friends, أَخِلَّاء. الْخُلَّة, when this goes this. خُلَّة. يعني, you know, we watch them, they get their blood. Okay, hit yourself with blood. Let's next the blood. I love you, man. I love you, dude. They will be enemies in the day of resurrection. Accept the righteous and the pious. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ. The transgressor will bite upon his hand. يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا. I wish I have followed the path of making myself a servant to Allah, a slave to Allah. I wish I have followed the path of the Prophet, the path of the Messenger. يا ويلتا ليتني لم أتخذ فلانا خليلا. Woe to me! I wish I have not taken that person for a friend. لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني. He misguided me. I used to talk to him about Allah, about the hereafter, about praying 5 times, about fasting, about being a good person, about not drinking, about leaving usury, about staying away from adultery, about enjoining good forbidding evil, about being kind to the parents. I used to tell him about all these things. I said, man, you believe in this stuff? You believe in this stuff? يا أخي هناك مشهد في سورة الصافات فأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتساءلون. The people in Jannah are in Jannah. The people of the hell are in hell. And the people of Jannah will sit in the sofas, reclining in the sofa, chatting, having a good talk, and remembering some of the things in this dunya. One of them will say, إِنِّي كَانَ لِي قَرِينَ. Man, in the dunya I used to have a friend. I don't see him here. And every time I talk to him about Allah, about the day of resurrection, about punishment, about this world is not the end of the journey. This world is just a testing place for you. And if you submit, then things will be good. And if you do not, then things will be awful and terrible. And he used to tell me, أَإِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُصَدِّقِينَ. Come on, man. You're a smart man. I mean, come on, you're a scientist. Huh? You got 3 PhDs. You believe in that sci-fi stuff? Come on. أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَدِينُونَ. When we die and we become dust and clay and ashes and bones, we're going to be held accountable. Come on, you smart guy. قَالَ هَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُطَّلِعُونَ. You know there is a wall between the hellfire and Jannah. Can you please help me? Let me look and see if I can see him in the hellfire. فَاطَّلَعَ فَرَآهُ فِي سَوَاءِ الْجَحِيمِ. He looked, he found him in the middle of the hellfire. He called upon him. قَالَ تَاللَّهِ إِن كِدْتَ لَتُرْدِينَ. By Allah, you almost got me in trouble. I almost believed you. I almost listened to you. وَلَوْلَا نِعْمَةُ رَبِّي لَكُنْتُ مِنَ الْمُحْضَرِينَ. And has it been for the favor and the bounty of Allah upon me, I would have been brought in your place too. أَفَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَيِّتِينَ. Look at us, we're not going to die anymore. إِلَّا مَوْتَتَنَا الْأُولَى. We already tasted death in this world. وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمُعَذَّبِينَ. And we will not be punished. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. This is the ultimate success. لِمِثْلِ هَذَا. For this, فَلْيَعْمَلِ الْعَامِلُونَ. Work. As for the third enemy, and I actually introduced the whole concept to begin talking about that enemy, which is Shaytan. شيطان الجن. Satan. Someone, أخي, sister, he doesn't like you from day one. He already sworn to be your enemy. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the Quran, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. A plain enemy. يا أخي أنا أعجب. أعجب. I'm amazed. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. والحديث في مصنف عبد الرزاق بسند صحيح وله شواهد في الصحيحين من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من مولود يولد إلا ويستهل صارخا. Any newborn who comes into this world, he starts crying. Why? You know why? Because Shaytan snaps him in the side. I'm here. I'm your enemy. A baby. A baby. How coward you can be. An infant. What did this infant do to you? Nothing. I'm just making sure that he knows that he is mine. Illa Maryama wabnaha. Except Maryam and her son, Isa. Because of the supplication of the mother. وَإِنِّي أُعِيدُهَا بِكَ وَدُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, who is Shaytan? Why he hates you so much? What is his story with your father Adam? What are his goals? How is he going about to achieve his goals? And how you protect yourselves from him? This is, inshallah, will be the topics of my maybe two or three khutbas to come, talking in detail about the third enemy and his tactics to make you his friend in the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned you in the Quran, saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقَّ فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. Oh, ye who believe, all these things are true, wallahi, wallahi true, wallahi true, be certain about it. Do not be deceived by this dunya and by the chief of this, the deceiver. قَالَ مُجَاهِدْ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ, meaning is shaytan. Here is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ. Shaytan is an enemy to you. فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. Take him, treat him as an enemy. إِنَّمَا يَدْعُو حِزْبَهُ لِيَكُونُوا مِنْ أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. He is calling you to be his friends, his companions in the hellfire. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعصمنا من الشيطان ومن شره ومن شركه ومن شركه. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم ألهمنا رشدنا وقنا شر نفوسنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت وإذا سئلت به أعطيت, أن تعصمنا يا رب العالمين من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ومن شياطين الإنس وشياطين الجن يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم إنا نسألك يا رب العالمين أن تنجينا من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم استرنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض يا رب العالمين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.